You know, there was nothing better to ring in my 20th birthday than the season 3 mid-finale of Star vs. the Forces of Evil, Monster Bash. This was seriously a game-changing episode, and it really puts into perspective Darren Nefcy's statement that this season is more Game of Thrones than the previous two. It wasn't in terms of how dark the story would be, but the actual concept of family competing for the powerful position as ruler. It's crazy how one simple reveal can change the entire course of the series and add context to so many mysteries and vague plot threads that was dangling in front of our faces for so long. In Monster Bash, Star throws a party between humans and monsters, the next step in her plan for peace when both Miss Haynes and Mina Loveberry put their respective plans into action. Haynes plans to finally get her revenge on Margo, for like the third time. While Mina was actually anticipating the arrival of Haynes, guarding the temple from monsters and being the source of vanishing guests. Haynes' cheeks begin to glow as the space-marked passage begins to open. At first, I thought Eclipsa had escaped Mina Castle and was going to make an entrance of her own, but in my opinion, what followed was even better. Everyone stumbles upon a room with monster statues, a crib, and two dolls, of none other than Eclipsa and her monster husband. I was just in absolute shock because I already knew where this was going. I couldn't believe it. I just kept saying, "No way, no way," under my breath. I literally made a theory about this 6 months ago, and seeing it come to fruition just blows my mind. We don't know yet the full extent and ramifications, but the core component of it was correct. It's revealed Miss Haynes' true identity is Meteor Butterfly, the daughter of Eclipsa and her monster husbando. Mina anticipated her return, aware that Eclipsa's reawakening may have led to this moment, and she wants to exterminate Meteoria as she's half monster. And while it isn't spoken, this has indirectly revealed the truth. This is the Butterfly family's darkest secret. Eclipsa wasn't crystallized because she ran off of a monster, it's because she gave birth to a hybrid. Monsters already have a negative connotation in Muni, and I still think Eclipsa's groom had a level of power above all monsters, in both status and raw strength. So having the offspring that's a mix of that and Butterfly, infused with magic, that could be a weapon of mass destruction. It's a very messed up situation to say the least. Meteoria is still human, she still has thoughts and emotions. And we see that monsters aren't necessarily mean and nasty as they were portrayed to be up until season 2. There's depth to them. As for Haynes constantly brainwashing herself, repressing her cheek marks, and by extension her memory, I believe either Eclipsa or her servants, maybe even Toffee himself, taught her that. And yes, I'm saying Toffee served Eclipsa. Eclipsa didn't want to risk her being caught, being found out and killed, so she masked Meteoria's true identity and hid her away. Now, as for why Haynes was going around and draining the youth out of princesses, it's apparent that's how she prolonged her life all these years. But I don't know if that's a solution she came up with or Eclipsa. It makes sense if Eclipsa put that plan into place, so if the day ever came that she was freed, they could reunite and be a family again. Although Haynes looks a lot older than Eclipsa, despite Eclipsa being her mother. So where do we go on from here? Star is distressed by not knowing who her family truly is. And if you refer back to Star and Marco's Guide to Mastering Every Dimension, Star states in that book, Moon specified Haynes wasn't related to them, which was an obvious lie. So I can't wait to see how this changes up their dynamic. With these resurfaced memories, Miss Haynes may drop wanting to reclaim St. Olga's Reform School and go after a much bigger prize, taking her rightful throne on Muni. As, let's be honest, it was very much snubbed from her, but I can also see Eclipsa coming after the throne. Maybe that's her grand plan. After all, queens aren't really impeached, and even though Eclipsa abandoned Muni for a monster, it was never stated Eclipsa relinquished her title from Muni, meaning she could still be queen. Star vs. the Forces of Evil is heating up, and I can't wait. This show has come so far. But as always, these are just my thoughts, and I definitely want to hear yours. Comment below or tweet your thoughts directly to me at AustricVods. You can follow the Roundtable on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, all at RoundtableVids, and we're also on Snapchat at RoundtableYT. We have a Discord, official Amino app, and Patreon. Don't forget to check out and snag a Roundtable t-shirt from our store. And if you do, thank you. Links to everything in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please sort of like, share it with your friends, and if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, it really helps us out. Hit that bell for notifications so you can stay in the loop with all things Star. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a beautiful day. AustricVods, out.